That's Ann Fuse you've just been listening to. Matter of fact, everything you've been listening to has been recorded here live at the showroom. Most of it unsuspecting of the people who were playing. But they're really glad we did. You know, because sometimes you don't need to know that you're being recorded. You just play to have fun. But we try to make it really comfortable for the musicians so they have a really good time. And we're hoping that the audience will do. We do our best to make that part work as well. Just a little, some updates here. We're just about at the $5,000 mark for the GoFundMe program, which we started up, which is going, wow. And that's like only 67 people. And I just tried to embarrass Vince Vaccaro about how some musicians have been putting in $100, $150. And I said, wow, that's really cool. I was only expecting twos, fives, and tens. And, you know, it's kind of laying it on thick. So he's just offered to come up and do a show where all the proceeds, he gets all the merch, but all the door would go to us. And I want to thank him very much. Vince Vaccaro, if you're listening tonight, he's in Australia. Thank you very much for putting that kind of stuff up. Of course, we couldn't pry the money out of his pocketbook, but the actual cash leaving his hand is difficult. But that's me and Vince. We have fun doing that. Some of the things that are coming up that are very interesting. There's a Easy Funk, Big Easy Funk Ensemble tomorrow night. We're going to be here sort of in a Mardi Gras feel. Seven-piece, eight-piece band. If we work out, it might be that extra horn will be here. Be way too cool. But something just came in on the plate tonight, which is very cool. And that is that Dan Hill is going to be hanging out here with a friend of his road manager and next-door neighbor for years. And they're going to be hanging out, coming in here, doing some recording of some new material. And then they're going to do a show here on next Wednesday night at 8 o'clock, last minute. Pretty darn cool. I'll let you know more about that when we get the tickets up for sale and all that. But tonight, this has been a dream come true for me. We had Eric Bibb here and that upstairs, and that was very cool. But if there's anyone who has that same kind of feel, that same kind of ability to take the blues and make it soothing, really soothing, and take you on a wonderful journey with it, is Rick Fiennes. He's just very, very good at that. I've been able to work with him over the years when he was with Jackson Delta, and he's done worked with Susie Vinnick, and I've seen him at all the folk alliances, which we're not at this year, by the way, because it's on this weekend, so we're not there. But today, on this little tour, he's brought Rolly Plata with him. And this is, I've heard of Rolly over the years. I know some people here have too, that they're out here to see him as well. The two of them together, wow, it's going to be a journey, a wonderful journey. Let's get them on stage, please.
Hey, thanks. Look, you're afraid of those front seats, eh? It's a mosh pit. Okay, I didn't realize that. But a soothing mosh pit. So we're going to start with a song that's from my latest CD, which is my Driving Home CD. And this song, I went through this dark period in my life and too many funerals to go to. And I lost my ability to live in the moment. And that was sort of stuck in my head, you know, with the little hamster wheel going around and around. And one day I woke up and I got my coffee and I sat in the dining room, and I literally woke up and smelled the coffee. You know, the coffee smelled great, and I looked outside and the sun was dancing through the leaves of the trees and lighting up flowers and everything was beautiful. And there I was present and in the moment again. So being a middle-aged man of European descent, I thought I'd better sit down and analyze the hell out of that. Will I have this one day free of form? I have this one day, I have nothing more. A new start I will direct, just where I may. Oh, I have this one day, an underwater world lies below. A too Lubbub under earth, under the snow. A possibility. Each precious moment alive, there's a galaxy of stars hidden in that sunny sky. And I have this one day, free of form. I have this one day, I have nothing more. A new start I will direct, just where I may. Oh, I have but this one day. Drift along like snowflakes blown, and I'm peaceful now with so much unknown. A million years it took to get this way, and I have this one day, and I have peace. To have so little is to have a new start. And I have love to spare. I have a life to live. And I have so much more left to give. Yes, I have but this one day, free of form. I have this one day and nothing more. A new start I will direct, just where I may. I have this one day. Thank you. I'm going to play some old blues for you here, something by Big Bill Brunzi. I've been listening to Big Bill a lot lately at home. I can just keep going back to him. He's just the well that you can keep coming back to. I got the key to the highway. Built up and bound to go. I'm gonna leave here right now, because walking's more goes too slow. I go on more over the mountain. Baby, well, I'm better known. Cause he ain't done nothing, darling, but drive a good man from his home. Yes, when the moon comes over the mountain, baby, I'll be on my way. You ain't done nothing, darling, that's gonna make me stay. Take you to cottage country in Ontario now. I'm looking down at that set list, and there's a bunch of cottage country songs there. So
Star Cottage Medley.
Driving home from the sort of northern Muskoka area, driving home to Peterborough. That's Peterborough, Ontario, home of the blues. And I was making my way down along the west side of Algonquin Park. And it was bleak and it was late in the autumn. It was late enough in the autumn that I should have really had my snow tires on. But I was in denial. And I wasn't even turning the heat on in the car. I was sort of seriously into denial about winter coming. And so as I get to the top of those big hills there, the sort of misty rain meets the clouds, and it would frost over at the tops of the hills, and the car would slide around, and I'd tell myself, when I get home, I'm putting my snow tires on. And then I crested one hill and I look and there's a straight line straight ahead of me. And not only is the road going straight and doing downhill for a long way, but it's going downhill enough that it's a change in altitude is what's happening. And and change in elevation. And as that happened, the clouds opened up and the sun started shining down in the car, and it started shining on hard enough that I had to roll the window down a little bit to cool it off in the car. I thought, this is interesting. It's like I'm changing climate zones or something. And there it was. There was that sign that I get whenever I get that epiphany. I happen to be driving by the same place, and there's the sign that says, Buttermilk Falls. But there's that sign again, Buttermilk Falls. And I promised myself right then and there, I'm never turning down that road. I'm not going to go see what Buttermilk Falls is, because I've got an idea, and it can't live up to it. There's no way. And so I pulled over to the side of the road because I heard a band in my head. I heard Van Morrison's band in my head, actually, and a song was coming to me. And so I used my latest songwriting technique, which is pull over to the side of the road. My previous songwriting technique was sing it into my phone while I drive down the road, but that costs $500 now. So I just pull over to the side of the road. I heard this horn section sounding very much like Roly Platt's harmonica, as a matter of fact.
Good. I'm really glad to hear that.
Buttermilk Falls, the autumn sunshine's a little stronger. Yes, and the leaves on the trees, they last a little longer. And white pines stand tall in Buttermilk Falls. First you come here to visit, then you become a part. Oh, first you know it in your mind, then you know it in your heart. And you remind yourself you're part of it all, and Buttermilk Falls. And Buttermilk Falls, the sky has its own shade of blue. Yeah, just like the birds in the trees, you never wonder what to do. Oh, it all becomes so clear, something called you.
World gets small and Buttermilk Falls.
place by the river where I like to go and sort through my thoughts where time's passage is slow. And where the willows droop over a deep little pool fit by the current, it's kept fresh and cool. For a tired little fish, it makes a nice resting place. The shimmering water and the trees' shadowy lace, a long forgotten bench sits covered in dew, where the east is azure and the west is the deepest of blue. Here's where I find my peace of mind, where the world is alive, where the world is kind. Here's where I start the best of my days. It's where birds sing and where fishes play. Solitude will be lost. Yet here's where I find my peace of mind, where the world is alive, where the world is kind. And here's where I start the best of my days, where birds sing. Fishes play.
My first time out here. What a funky, amazing spot this is for music. I love this. It's about as funky as I am, which is pretty funky. This is a tune written by not me, but a harmonica player from Paris, France, by the name of Jean-Jacques Milteau, J.J. Milteau. And so I learned it. That was a great kind of cross a country and blues. And I'm very proud of myself because I don't speak a word of French, but I spent ages studying this tune, and it helps that it's an instrumental, mind you, but I'm going to do it now, and you may be able to detect a little bit of French accent in this. Thank you very much.
Another one? Sure.
I'm going to do another one.
All right. Good mind to one. Okay.
What was that? What did I miss? Yeah. Well, this is a German harmonica, as most of them are. This is a tune from my CD. I did my debut CD 2 years ago when I was 56. And I wrote on the CD that every 56 years, I put out a CD. So please don't wait for the next one, because it's not going to be that good. This is a song from that CD. It's an original tune that I wrote with blues great Steve Strongman. I'm not sure if you're familiar with Steve, but if he comes out this way, check him out. He's a real powerhouse, great musician and great writer. And he sang it on the record. I'm singing it tonight because he ain't here. It's called Good Mind to Wander. You weren't alone. always gets the best of me. That's never happened to me.
We'll do a song now. I like to introduce this song as the song that made me realize I needed counseling. See, I audited a psychology course at Trent University, so I knew there was something wrong when I was writing a song for my wife, and I only got two verses into it when I found myself writing about my mother. I bet you they're not sure if I'm joking or not. I bet they won't know. Started it quite like that before.
He does need counseling.
Yes.
Thank you.
wish there was some way that I could ease your mind. You can barely get yourself to sleep at night over some little thing you said, some little thing that you said that you worried was misread. It keeps on racing all around and round your head. Yourself not good enough, and you could never measure up, somehow never quite enough. You thought you never measured up. I wish that I could show you that half full cup. Now please, now don't you worry, you're not misunderstood, you know, anyone who could would be half as good. Don't you worry, you're not misunderstood. Saw you as a beacon, or shining like the sun. Oh yes, and always lots of fun. You know you shine just like the sun. Always a beacon, and always there for everyone.
try switching to G here. Let's play something in G. Key of G.
Why not?
I bought a beautiful guitar for playing slide that I was going to leave out here. Bought it up in Nanaimo. But then I took it in to get it fixed up, and that cost $800. So I decided I need to play this guitar more often than just leaving it around here to come visit it once a year. So I took it home. So I have to find another one, because the third piece of luggage now costs $100 each way when you're flying. So otherwise, I have to just keep tuning these guitars all over the place. Let's see. But I do have my West Coast slide here, my Hornby Island glass slide. Floor dancing all night long like this. No tomorrow.
listen to the sounds. Oh, tell me now, how can I sleep with a blues band cooking just six doors down? And it'll get late into the evening, I should be bedded down. I ought to be sleeping, I should be sleeping sound. It'll get late into the evening now, I should be sleeping sound. With a blues band cooking just six doors down. I tell me now, why would I sleep? I got a blues band cooking just six doors down. When I was just a child, I heard my mama and papa talking. They see, I knew it was my mama, because she's got a voice very much like John Lee Hooker. And I heard my mama tell my papa, you gotta let that boy boogie woogie, because it's in him. It's got to. Not a word of lie. It's all true stories here tonight. Well, I felt so good, I stayed out in boogie woogie all night long. Well, I felt so good, people, I boogie woogie all night long. And in the back of my mind, I heard John Lee Hooker say, sit boogie chillin'. Thank you.
first got to town. I was wandering all around. Heard everybody talking about Duncan Showroom. So I decided I'd go down there one night. When I got there, man, when I got there, say yes, now people, they were really, really having a time. I said, Lord, 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 now people, they were really, really having a ball. But they're doing it very Canadian style. Just sort of sitting there calmly, wiggling their bum just a tiny little bit. But I heard this harmonica player, man, knocked me out. I had to hear some more. Boogie chillin'.
Take us out with a song. I'll get this tuned up, you introduce it, and then, yeah.
Hi again. This is a song also on my CD, and I like to play blues. I like to play, I kind of grew up playing a little country, a little bit of everything. And one of the things I learned, not this particular song, but of this style, was my very first band, the Cement City Stompers in Toronto. Yes, we have an almost member of the band, a brother of the member of the original band. And our fearless leader, Phil Lloyd, who's not with us anymore, but you guys would have liked him. He was an amazing guy. He's one of those guys that could piss you off, like do the work, like not show up for something, like a gig or something like this, or some other crazy thing, and then 2 weeks later, you see him walk in the club, and he's got this grin on his face, like, and you go, you know, come here. One of those guys, but always brought a smile to the room wherever he came. And my favorite time was after the gig. We'd be on the road somewhere, and he always carried this little parlor guitar with him. And he'd pull it out from under the bed, it'd be 2 a.m, and he'd start doing all these old jazz tunes. And not ones that we did on stage, but all these ones that his mom taught him. And this wasn't one of the particular tunes, but it was certainly in his vein. This is a song that version I got it from was Ray Charles, and it's called Georgia.
One, two, three. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That's for Phil Lloyd and the Cement City Stompers. He would have liked that one.
We'll take a short intermission and we'll be back with you for another set.
Nakuterekeranga nze mwana wange gwe wesirikire gwe
Sometimes I get weary hearing the news. It's really no news at all. It's the same old story. Brothers killing brothers. They haven't heard the news. Well, I'm so glad there's a new world. Keep your mind on it, shine your light on it, talking about the new world coming through. We walk down our streets, looking over our shoulders, trying to make it home safe and sound. Somewhere where no one wants to harm you. Well, meet me in the new world coming through. Keep your mind on it, shine your light on it, talking about the new world coming through. Scared to lose our jobs, or still trying to find one. Who's pulling the strings is hard to tell. All that's got to end. We're coming round the bend into a new world coming to. Keep your mind on it, shine your light on it, don't give up on it, 'cause you know you want it too. I'm talking about a new world, I'm talking about a new world, I'm talking about a new world coming through. Come on, clap your hands. Keep your mind on it, shine your light on it, don't give up on it, 'cause you know you want it too. I'm talking about the new world, I'm talking about the new world, I'm talking about the new world coming through. Keep your mind on it, shine your light on it, don't give up on it.
That's right.
Everybody knows.
Listen to the band, they're playing just for me. Listen to the people paying just for me.
see you in all of the faces of the men on White Avenue and in that chilly bar where I first served drinks to you. I hear you in all the footsteps of the men on 109. Such a lonely sound when I hang my head and cry. I will love you for now that you're gone. I need you more than ever. I'm still holding. Try to find peace and forgiveness. These days is too hard. May the Lord be my only witness. Yes, I love you forever. Now that you're gone, I need you more than I'm still holding. Still holding on. Still holding on to you. I see you in all faces of the men on White Avenue in that chilly bar where I first met you.
like you've been hurt. Oh, and baby, we won't let it change things, direct us blind.
You ever seen one of these? All by blowing out your nose. Much like the harmonica, no one really wants to borrow it. Or shouldn't borrow it. You know, the unfortunate thing is when you get the sniffles like I got right now, it's called snot music. Ew, now it's in my finger. No, just joking. Hey, you enjoy yourself for a set? Isn't there just like, these guys are just like the smoothest. It's like, ooh, loving it. Slide like that, I've never heard a harmonica playing. And singing. I really like that one about the Muskokas. I played that CD going out of style up at my little house on Givens Road. Always thought of all the McKinnon family and all those guys up there. That's I got introduced to that whole Bracebridge area because of you guys and Pat and everything like that, right? Now I realize what cottage country is. You always hear about cottage country until you've been up there. That's kind of a neat area. Many more shows coming up. We're out of programs tonight, which is great. That means I made an extra 50 this week and managed to get rid of all of them without even going to the stores. So that means we're getting more and more popular, and that's very good to see. There'll be a new one out on tomorrow afternoon or Saturday morning. I'm usually out down at the market handing them out. Many great shows coming up, but tonight you're here for this one, right? Rick Fiennes and Rolly Platt. Let's get him back on stage again.
I'm going to sit down, Rolly. Uh-oh. Yeah.
That was a long set. Was it really?
I don't know. That's what I want. Clunk. Takes a good clunk. I think we're going to start off with a song that I wrote back in the 1920s. When I was just a young woman in my prime. Just getting started in this crazy business. It'll do funny things to you, the music business. You know, what was that? I'm still pretty good. Oh, thank you. Gosh. You know, we were talking about, like anybody in any business, you can spend a lot of time whining about things about being in whatever business you're in, and it's easy to do. But in our case, it certainly quickly turns around to talking about how blessed we are and how everywhere we travel, you know, we see the whole country all the time and we have so many good friends. And it's through the kindness of strangers that we
get to meet people united by music, and then they become friends, and years later and decades later, you just keep going around and seeing your old friends again. And it's what a beautiful life. Yeah. This is actually my little tribute to the great women blues singers of the 1920s and 30s who were the first big stars in blues music, and it's important to remember that because there are so many middle-aged guys with guitars playing blues for people, and generally they talk about guys with guitars. So it's important to remember that that without people like Georgia White and Ida Cox, and without people like Bessie Smith, they were the big stars in the first place when blues first hit the map. This is called I Just Got Back. I just got back, and that is to say, I've been trying to push my blues away. Oh, but I pushed you away instead, with all my talking all out of my head. I've been on some kind of trip, but I just got back. And you've been so good to me while I've been blue. You seem to understand all that I have been going through. Well, now things are looking up. Baby, I'm so long and so down on my love. I've been on some kind of trip, but I just got back.
I'll take you on a trip, Rolly.
Started walking on the sunny side of the street again, my friend. And how happy I'm gonna be if you'd only come out dancing with me. See, I've been on some kind of trip, but I just got back.
Oh, can you give us one more of those?
From our sponsor. If you're going to try to play mouth trombone, you will irritate your throat. And when you do, the only thing that can give you any relief is fisherman's friends, I want to tell you. Those other cough drops are just candies, really. Fisherman's friends, it's good medicine. Really works. I'm going to play another song that I wrote by pulling over to the side of the road. I had a lot on my mind, and I had to go off and work and go out and leave home and get on the road and work for a couple of weeks shortly after my father had died. So I don't know if you've ever heard of this, but as a man, I have a special built-in feature where I was able to suppress and push down my emotions and bury them deep inside. Which comes in handy. But I was on my way home, and they just seemed to all start releasing themselves. And all I had to do was drive from Ottawa to Peterborough. Long John, you know the drive from Ottawa, don't you? Indeed. So all I had to do, really, was take the Highway 7 from Ottawa to Peterborough. And I looked up, and I remember thinking how very strange that they would move the entire town of Arnprior down to the Highway 7. Turns out I had just missed my one and only turn, and I was on the 417 heading toward North Bay. So I took the back roads, and I drove through all those little towns that we played rock and roll in when I was in my 20s. I was a rock star in places like Renfrew and Eganville, places like Maynooth and Bancroft. But those days are gone, and all those gigs, all those wonderful gigs where you could play sometimes five nights a week and stay in some pre-war bed above this old hotel. All that stuff is gone, and so I don't know. You know, people don't get the kind of music that they used to get. You know, but like you're privileged to have right here. I mean, with the amount of music that comes through this joint right here, it's pretty astonishing. So anyway, I started thinking about all that and about my troubles on my mind, and I pulled over and I wrote this song here called "Driving Home." And on this particular occasion, it goes precisely like this. With this frost on the windshield, and the sun's getting stronger, I think I'll drive on through the valley, take a little longer along. Emotions set in motion seem to drive the bus as I think about you and us. And there's something in these old back roads driving home. Soft wind this morning, and the hills are oh so green from the past.
last come the stories with every scene down this road. Oh, and I love the scent of lilacs on this spring breeze, sets my heart at ease. It's the smell of hope itself driving home.
I'm really happy to be here on this trip, and particularly this gig here. This is very cool. You guys are very cool for coming. And I'd like to do, in honor of that, I'd like to do an uplifting spiritual number. A hush fell over the crowd. This is it's a song, an original song on my CD, and there's a little video on YouTube if you want to check it out as well that I did the video up as well. And it's called Ripping It Up.
Church hall, ripping it up, ripping it up.
knows when St. Peter's gonna call, so they're ripping it up at the old church hall. Now look at Jim, he's a dancing fool. He learned to do it in Sunday school. You may think that he's over the hill, but he can twist and grind like a pepper mill. And God knows he's having a ball. He's ripping it up at the old church hall. St. Peter's gonna call, so they're ripping it up at the old church hall. Lifting spiritual number.
Yeah. All
that's
right.
The kind of church I like.
Ooh, like that. What's that? Rainbow. Yeah, sure. Yeah. Of course. Here's an obscure song you'll never heard before, but when Roly plays it for you, you'll feel like you've known it all your life. The one you're going to do.
Okay, good.
Nothing but true stories.
That's
here.
Right.
Nothing but true stories.
I think you will find this one very familiar. This is a song also on my CD. And people ask me why I waited so long to do a CD, you know, 56 years. I said, I play harmonica for a living. It took me this long to save enough money to do one. Jesus. This is a little departure. There's a lot of blues on the CD. And like I said before, I like to play a lot of different styles. This is obviously a classic tune, and it's on the CD, and so there. For all the people that go, that's not a blues song. That's right.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was an original tune.
This next song is a song that I thought I was writing inspired by a Carol Shields short story from her very first book of short stories. But I discovered that I was in fact just ripping it off wholesale. But I learned an important lesson, that is if you take Mississippi John Hurt's style of guitar playing and then boil it down and get rid of all the extras and then you add Carol Shields' words, you get a John Prine song. And that makes this the only John Prine song I've ever written. What I loved about that short story was that Carol captured the same moment in time from three different perspectives, and I just loved that. This is called Mrs. Turner is a Sight, based on Mrs. Turner cutting the grass. Mrs. Turner is a sight as she cuts the grass. And the girls walking by are checking out her ass. And the layers of flesh stacked on her thighs. At her age, does she not realize? Short shorts make you queasy. They just don't suit her. The girls feel uneasy and a little fearful of the future. With that halter top on, man, she's got some kind of style. But as Mrs. Turner looks up, well, those girls all smile. 'Cause it's a friendly place, and people keep their houses nice. A little too much rain, but there's a beach nearby. Tom and Sally, they catch an eye as Mrs. Turner tends her lawn. Man, she sure seems to try, but she's got it all wrong. Why, it's like there's spots that she's purposely skipping, and she's got no catcher to catch the clippings. That Mrs. Turner, she's a sight with her electric lawnmower. If she can't get it right, she oughtn't do it anymore. Seems she does a whole lot less good than harm. But as Mrs. Turner looks up, well, Tom and Sally wave their arms. 'Cause it's a friendly place, and people keep their houses nice. Not enough rain, but there's a beach nearby. Turner, she's happy as she flings the cord. Man, she's got her hair all stuffed up in that old hat. Belonged to Gord. And
cord planted this lawn. It seems like just yesterday. 10 years now he's been gone. It was a Saturday. Girlie flies overseas now. Every year with her sisters. Well, they went off to France one time. And some stranger kissed her. Now she's sleeping on a bed that's on the floor in a hotel in Japan. When she sees the young girls smile and sees the neighbors wave their hands, and it's a friendly place. People sure keep their houses nice, but there's just enough rain and a beach nearby. Twice before I walked inside. The dealer came to me and he said, trade in your Ford and I'll put you in a car. Boy, I'm gonna eat up the road. Just tell me what you like and sign this here line I have brought down to you in 1 hour's time. So I'm gonna get in my car and I'm gonna cruise it up and down the road. My broke down ragged Ford. Mister, I'd like a yellow convertible. I would like a four-door DeVille with Continental spare, and I want wire chrome wheels, Harley heads, dual exhaust. I burn aviation fuel, no matter what that stuff costs. I want automatic air, automatic heat, a fold-out bed back in my back seat. I want a CB radio, I want a TV and a phone. I talk to my baby when I ride the road, and then I'm gonna get in my car and cruise it up and down the road. Not gonna worry anymore about my broke down ragged Ford. Thank you. gonna spend all my hard-earned money on some brand new automobile. I wanna make sure I get every available option behind the wheel. Now, being the classy kind of guy that I am, I want a classy kind of car. Something with dingo balls and fuzzy dice. I think a leopard skin motif sure would be nice. I want a railroad air horn and a military spy. I want a 5-year guarantee on all that I got. I want a $10 deductible. I pay you in $20 notes. It's a $300,000 building, baby, and that's all she wrote. And I go get in that car and cruise it up and down the road. I'll take it up to Chemainus, I tell ya. I'm not gonna worry anymore about my broken ragged Ford.
Got another song there for us?
That's a good question. I have so many.
Go ahead. Oh, I was thinking that instrumental there.
Which one?
Mad River?
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
I do have another song. So I am a professional harmonica player. Right? You imagine the look on my mom's face when I told her that was my career decision. And also knowing now that you know I'm a professional harmonica player, it's going to be a shock to you, but I didn't finish high school. So I'm leaving high school. I'm leaving. And the teacher says, "Well, you can't just leave." He says, "You got to go talk to the principal." So I said, "Okay, I'll go down and talk to him." He says, "Well, Mr. Platt," he says, "do you have a job to go to?" I said, "No." He says, "Well, what do you plan on doing?" I said, "Well, actually, I'd like to be a musician." He says, "Oh, musician, great." He says, "What do you play?" I said, "Harmonica." There was this silence, much like this. And he's kind of, you can see him thinking, and he says, "Do you play anything else?" And I just went, "Okay, thanks. Nice talking to you." So I'd like to dedicate this song to that principal. This is on my CD as well. It's called Mad River.
Thank you.
I had a little bit of madness going on there myself. All right. How are you guys doing? You feel like a few more songs? All right. I'm going to play a little song. Rolly, this one's going to be in the key of D. I like to keep him on his toes. There's no sense telling him, letting him know all the songs.
Don't
you
give
know?
Me too much information.
Yeah. So this song, I was writing this song with my friend. I've been writing a few songs with my friend Grania Ryan, and she writes wonderful songs. She had, we wrote a couple of them together and that were ideas that I had, and I brought them to her, and she helped me out, and we finished them all off. And then I said, well, if you got an idea for a song we can get started on, and she played me this little thing. This thing is, went like this, and it was, I Wanna Go Driving was the way it starts off, right? And I was thinking, oh, gee, I just wrote Driving Home. I kind of out of all my driving stuff, you know. I don't know what I'm going to do on this one. And then the turnaround on it is, I want to go driving and maybe I'll find love somewhere along the way. So I went home with this idea to work on it. And I thought, well, you know, Grania is younger than me, and she's single. And if she wants to go driving and maybe find love along the way, that's fine. But I'm a middle-aged married man, and if I go driving looking for love, it's a creepy thing, you know? It's like, you know what? I can't write that song. I don't know how I'm going to write that song. So I then started thinking about what it's like in this music business, and I thought, I'll use driving as a little metaphor. And I came back with this idea, and I said, Grania, that song that you brought last time, she said, no, I hate it, no. And I said, no, I got another idea. And we sat down, we wrote this, I think it turned out all right. I'm tired of driving, being in control. I wanna be a passenger and just let it roll. I wanna feel the rhythm of the trees at night. Yellow moon, indigo sky. I get caught in the hustle, keeping things in motion, keeping irons in the fire and such crazy notions. Roll the windows down, you can drive. Yellow moon, indigo sky, the deepest blue you've ever set eyes on. What it's made you, I wanna make this fly. See the shining truth on the horizon. Yellow moon, indigo sky.
this little song that a little exploration in grief, this song. Before my mother passed away, I knew she was going to pass away, and I tried to start processing that, writing song and figuring, putting that into some sort of perspective, and which, of course, is an impossible task, but that's what you do if you write songs. So I didn't get it finished until after she had passed away. It was the spring. I had written all sorts of verses, but most of them I didn't feel like singing. But when spring came, and spring was absolutely beautiful, I was rather astonished. I expected spring to be veiled in gray and have lost its magic. But it was sparkling and effervescent, and it was absolutely gorgeous out, which I credited to my mother immediately. I thought, well, she did that. She just said, hey, let's give you this. It's been a long winter. And that's what made me write a different verse and then sort of throw away most of the other ones. The air is rich with the scent of last year's leaves. Where they fell, where they lie and where they fade. And the snow, it still remains on the north side of the trees. On the north side of the trees, in the shade. All the winds of time change like a river free. A river free from its banks. River wild, and my heart is adrift with the one I have lost. With this loss, I am a child. As if nothing has changed, comes the warmth and the light of spring, oddly more beautiful now. And I'm left here to witness the glory of it all, though I watch from a distance. Well, who are the winds of time, are like a river free from its banks, a river wild, and my heart, it is adrift with the one I've lost. Lost, I am a child. Thank you. All right. play you a little song called Riley Wants His Life Back. Actually, this has got a fun story that goes with, along with my mom. Mom was proud mom right up to the very end, and so this is a song that I wrote many years ago when I entered into a competition, the International Songwriting Competition. And I entered in because B.B. King was one of the judges for the blues category. And if I could make it to the finals, then B.B. King would have to listen to my music. And my mother had a good collection of B.B. King albums. And so I won the thing. I won first place. Thank you. And my mother, and when she was in remission, heard that B.B. King was coming to Winnipeg. And so she decided she would collect up those albums that I grew up with, B.B. King albums. She had 4 or 5 of them, and take them to the arena in Winnipeg, listen to B.B. King, and get him to sign these up. So she gets, at the end of the concert, she's standing there in line. She gets to the front of the line, and a great big security guy working for Mr. King comes up and says, "Well, that'll be it. There'll be no more autographs. Thank you very much. We're closing things up." My mother, 5'2" and not 100 pounds, starts saying, "B.B.! B.B.!" on either side of this mountain of a man. And B.B. King sitting there says, "Send her on through." And he sits there signing them up and telling her, "You know, I'm glad you came, Eleanor, because I'm not going to be around for long. And I don't think I'll be making it back to Winnipeg. I'm tired, and the diabetes has taken its toll, and I just don't have the energy to do this anymore. So I don't think I'll be making it back here for another concert, so I'm glad you came." And he signs up them all, and he hands them back to her, and he goes to stand up. And you got to understand, that was quite an effort for him. He'd been sitting down for his concerts for at least a decade at this point. And so as he starts to lift himself up, my mother says, "No, wait, there's one more." And he looks at her, and she pulls out my Riley Wants His Life Back CD. He says, "My son wrote this song," and he takes it, and he says, "I know that song, but I've never seen this before." He said, I remember this, but I've never seen this. They just gave me a CDR with all the songs burned onto it. He said, "I'll tell you what, how about you sign this to me?" And my mom writes, "To B.B., love, Eleanor," and passes him my CD. And B.B. King stands up and walks away with it. And 6 months later, neither of them are here anymore, you know, 6 months after that. So for my mom, I'm going to get you to help us sing this, sing our night out here. You got 2 lines you have to sing. One of them is Riley Wants His Life Back. Riley being, of course, B.B. King's actual first name. But it's a play on the old... living the life of Riley. And the other line is, "And he wants his life back." So help me out. Riley wants his life back. Just like that. Riley wants his life back. Only a lot louder. Riley wants his life back. Everybody. Riley wants his life back. Well, I just picked up the phone. I was half awake. And this is what the party on the phone had to say. "Mr. Fines, your services are no longer required. You've done a fine job. It's not a case of being fired. But the boss is coming home, and he's back on track. And Mr. Riley's going to want to have his life back." Riley wants his life back. Riley wants his life back. He would sincerely like to thank you now for taking up the slack. But he's coming home now, and he wants his life back. All this started several months ago. You see, I did not have a job, and I'd been running out of dough. When I met this guy, Riley, I'd never seen before. And he said he needed someone to mind the store. He said, "By minding the store, what I mean to say is to take care of my affairs while I'm away. Now there's a maid for the housework, there's a gardener for the garden, and me, I really must be running now, if you will beg my pardon." Then he showed me the way,
and he tossed me his keys. And since then, I've been living this life of ease. But now with this news, I'm having anxiety attacks, you see, because Riley's coming home. Riley wants his life back. Riley wants his life back. Yes, I had his job, but now I'm getting sacked, cause Riley's coming home. Well, I got inside that door and I saw he had written me a note. So I sat myself down just to read what he wrote. He said there are certain social functions where I'm expected to be, and I'm gonna be needing you to sub in for me. See, it's billiards every Wednesday. That'll be the third door on your right. And we golf most afternoons, then it's to the clubhouse at night. So it seems what he had in mind, what he needed done, was a bunch of hanging out with his buddies and just having lots of fun. Now, just when I'm getting used to caviar and fine cognac, Riley shows up and he wants his life back. Riley 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 wants his life back. Hey, Roldy. What do you think of that Roly Platt? Now, far be it from me to accuse Roly Platt of living the life of Riley. But I will take it as far as to say you gotta have a little spare time on your hands to learn how to play harmonica that well. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. People, I've lived the life of Riley. Let me tell you, it was a buzz. I just sat around writing poems about how good my life was. With a big house and pool, all very private. I had such a great big long car, I needed some sucker to drive it. Booze and food and money, not one little thing did I lack. And now this Riley shows up. He wants his life back. Riley wants his life back. That's not fair. Riley wants his life back. It's not right. Riley wants his life back. I'm not standing for it. Riley wants his life back, but he's not getting it. I'm settling in. Thank you so much. A big hand for Tim doing the sound, doing a great job on the sound. And thanks, John, all these years. Thanks so much. Thanks, everybody, for coming out. Oh, Roly, we better just do another song here. We better just play another song.
Okay.
All right. Well, I think we'll maybe take things out with a song that was on the first album I ever bought when I was 12 years old. And sort of that'll bring things around in a circle for me, you know. Now, this is a song written by the two oldest and most decrepit bluesmen left on the planet. Of course, I'm speaking of Mick Jagger and Keith Richards. It's going to sound better if I put it down to that note, I bet.
Yeah, I saved up my pennies and I went down to stop 322 in Peterborough to buy Rolling Stones.
Then it's gone.
temptations to pass through here again. Thanks so much, very much. Appreciate it.
Yeah.